This is the Pixel 9 Pro, and I've been using it all week to fully immerse myself in Android, which I haven't done since the HTC Hero on Sprint. And I gave up my iPhone for the entire week. Well, that was gonna be the title of this video, but then I realized ecosystem lock-in is a real thing. More on that in a second. But I put it through its paces, taking pictures, video, using it for grocery shopping, loading in all the apps that I would typically use on my iPhone, trying to find alternatives for things like notes and tasks. And I found in the last week that there are several features on Android and the Pixel that I really prefer over the iPhone. But there's also a lot of things I still prefer about the iPhone. So let's get into the hardware. This year, Google redesigned the Pixel 9 Pro, honestly, to match some of the recent iPhone designs. Flat edges, shiny stainless steel sides, which honestly look really great. This is the Pixel 9 Pro in porcelain color. And I went with the Pixel 9 Pro XL, which is a very similar size to the iPhone 15 Pro Max, maybe a hair larger, but it felt great in the hand and I love the display. Recent Android phones that I've used, like the Pixel 6a, had that lower refresh rate display. And I find that the Pixel 9 Pro display looked great. Nothing about this display made me want for my iPhone. It's really high quality. And I also find that Touch ID on the Pixel 9 Pro is really fast and accurate. On older Pixels, I found that fingerprint sensor under the screen to be unreliable and not work very fast. But the Pixel 9 Pro, it works great. I mean, sometimes I don't even see the lock screen. It just straight up unlocks, goes right to the home screen. Design-wise, I think the phone looks great. But I will say, this camera bump, I'm not sure how I feel about it. My co-host on Primary Technology says every camera bump is ugly, which I don't know if I agree, but you can listen to Primary Technology, my show with Jason A10, links above and in the description. But when it comes to camera bump, I mean, I get physics are a thing and we need to accommodate massive lenses, but aesthetically, I think I still prefer the iPhone 15 Pro Max camera bump as opposed to this visor. When I posted photos of this, I got many posts showing various Star Trek characters and Futurama. And I mean, this camera bump is significant. It's basically more like a mesa than a bump, if you know what I mean. But overall, the hardware is great. So let's get into the software wins. There are some features on Android that I discovered when using this phone that I really prefer. For instance, maybe I want to share a YouTube video from my channel. Well, if I go there and let's copy a link, now that it's on the clipboard here on the Pixel 9 Pro, I can go over to Threads or X, and then even after I type something to post, actually right here above the keyboard is the link that I have on the clipboard. Love that I can just quickly tap it and paste it without having to actually tap here in the post, find paste in the contextual menu and do that. Compare that to iPhone, I can copy the link, I can go over to Threads, write a post, but I would love just to be able to tap and paste whatever's on my clipboard. Instead, I kind of have to tap in the blank spot, find the contextual menu, and then it's there. So, cool little feature on Android. I also find that typing on the Pixel, or just on Android in general, is simply more accurate. I don't know if I'm making less mistakes or just the autocorrect is better, but I just found less mistakes, less having to go backwards than when I'm typing on my iPhone. There's cool features like hold up your hand for a few seconds in the selfie camera, it'll scan it and then actually start a timer to take a selfie. That's pretty cool. And overall, I know a lot of people say notifications are better on Android. Now, I didn't get a ton of notifications in the week I was using it, although Amazon did send me a lot of ads like this. Maybe they were better, but I have to say with Apple Intelligence on my iPhone 15 Pro Max right here, at least in beta, I've actually liked the summaries I get in things like mail and in all my notifications now, which was a recent feature in the latest 18.1 beta. You can check out my video on that above or the links in the description. I didn't find that I vastly preferred notifications on Android versus iPhone, but again, I do like the summaries from Apple Intelligence. Now, when it comes to individual apps on Android, many of the ones that I use all the time, like Pocket Cast for podcast listening, works great. It's cross-platform, it syncs all my content, my currently playing, follow list, those things work great. Also, I dusted off my 1Password account, logged in here, and 1Password works really great on Android. I actually think the autofill is a little faster than it is on the iPhone. And I put as many apps as I could in here, like Amazon, did some orders through there, added all my social media apps, and also AnyList, which is what I use for grocery shopping. Did a whole grocery run with AnyList on the Pixel 9 Pro. All that worked great. And I did find there were a lot of apps available for both platforms. Spark for email, which again, my co-host Jason A10 on Primary Tech, he uses it and loves it. Slack, of course, is here. Riverside for recording podcasts right from my mobile device. The New York Times for the all-important Wordle. There are a lot of apps that are available here on Android. But this is where things take a turn. Some of my most favorite apps, the ones that I use for notes and calendar, there is no Android equivalent. When it comes to note apps, there is no Bear app. There's no Things from Cultured Code or Fantastical for calendars. And I found when I looked for alternatives to some of my favorite apps on the iPhone, there just wasn't a great selection on Android. Take Notes, for example. When you search for a Notes app in the Play Store, after you get past these sponsored apps and apps that are just blatantly ripping off Apple's icon, I don't know what this limited time events thing is, but you really don't get good results until you scroll down a few screens here in the Play Store. Again, these suggestions for you, I didn't find particularly useful. Now, I asked on Threads, and there were a lot of recommendations for things like UpNote and Joplin, Simple Note, which actually are cross-platform. And a lot of people just said use Google Keep because that integrates with Google Gemini, it has tasks and notes, and it's available on all platforms. You can get it on iPhone and Android. And so that's what I did. I have Google Keep here on my iPhone and here on my Android device. Started a note here for this Pixel 9 Pro review, and it's fine. Just for a plain note-taking app, putting some links in, adding some images and tasks. I mean, it's okay. But even with all those recommendations, I just did not find an app I loved as much as Bear. Also, not one as much as Fantastical or Things on the iPhone. Overall design, usability, UI, I just prefer the apps on the iPhone. There are a lot of good apps on Android and a few great apps, but I think there are lots of great apps on the iPhone, and you just have a wider selection of those higher quality apps. Now, a few other software quirks. We'll just stay here in Google Keep. Obviously, here on the iPhone, you can tap and hold on the spacebar, and moving the cursor around the note, super easy and super fast. I found trying to move the cursor here on the Pixel, you can tap and hold on the spacebar, but moving it is really cumbersome. Doesn't really go up and down very well, and you really have to go far over to get the cursor where you want it, and so it takes several swipes on that spacebar. Again, compare that to the cursor here on the iPhone, and I can go up and down anywhere I want without taking my thumb off the keyboard. Cursor movement, iPhone definitely wins. Also, when it comes to just stock applications like Gmail on the Pixel and the stock Mail app on iPhone, I find that the stock Mail app on iPhone is just better. Has more features, things like VIP notifications. And the Gmail app on Android has this weird behavior where I can't add a Google account, but also keep it out of the all inboxes view. If I add a Gmail account, it has to be there. Whereas here on iPhone, I can add an account and include it in the Mail app or not, just sync the notes or not, or choose what to toggle on and off. I would really love for Android to have that feature so I could use the stock Gmail app. Another feature that I really miss from the iPhone is focus modes. I have multiple focus modes. You see here, I actually have my filming one on right now, plus ones for the weekend and the evening. And there is a digital well-being here on the Pixel 9 Pro and even a focus mode setting, but you only get one focus mode and you just don't have the granular control that you do in focus modes on iPhone. Things like the focus filters, third-party apps that can integrate with focus filters, and more. Also, if you follow this channel at all, you know that shortcuts are a huge deal, huge part of my workflows. And not having those shortcuts on Android was actually a massive loss. I didn't even want to do Wordle on the Pixel because I actually have a shortcut for when I'm finished doing Wordle to actually have a little custom message and then auto-text it to a bunch of groups and people every time I complete it. And if I were to do that on the Pixel, I'd have to manually text it to everybody. That's a simple example, but also my shortcuts for sharing my podcast, creating frames around screenshots, intercoms with HomePods, which again goes to ecosystem lock-in, we'll get to that. Not having shortcuts is just a huge loss for me. I also miss the quick spotlight search just by swiping down on the home screen. I know if you swipe down, you get notifications, and if you swipe up, you get the app library, but to tap there in the Google search and then to type an app, I just find it to be a little more cumbersome. I feel much faster swiping anywhere in the home screen down and searching quickly. And one of the things that I thought the Pixel 9 Pro would solve, especially with the higher refresh screen, and yes, I have that setting enabled where it will go to 120 hertz. See right there, I have smooth display enabled. It is something about the scrolling. I don't know what it is, but I just do not feel it is as fluid as the iPhone. I don't know if it's an inertia thing or just something about how it stops when it's done scrolling. I just find scrolling on the iPhone still better. Even in a social media app like Threads on iPhone and here on Android, the scrolling just feels a little more jerky, just not as smooth as it is on the iPhone. Maybe that's just my own iPhone bias, but I still notice scrolling in general, which is something you do all day on these phones, I still prefer it on iPhone. And before I get to the ecosystem lock-in, I do want to mention the camera, because the Pixel 9 Pro has a very good camera. Took it to the beach at sunset. All these pictures and videos you're about to see were taken directly on the phone. The 48 megapixel selfie camera is also great. Took this selfie with Andrew Clare. Awesome YouTube channel. Definitely subscribe to him as well. And I would be very happy with all the photos and video that the Pixel 9 Pro takes. Although I did find that the camera app itself can feel a little jerky, especially switching between lenses, going from the ultra wide to the 5X, switching between them. Sometimes it takes a second, there's lag. And just overall, it felt like a little unpolished, like maybe there's some software updates that need to come to make that experience a little smoother. It rarely impacted the photo I was taking. Sometimes if I was capturing video and tried to switch lenses while I was recording, then it does have kind of that jerky movement. But when it comes to picture and video quality, the Pixel 9 Pro looks great overall. But let's get to the real rub. If I were to actually want to switch to Android and use the Pixel 9 Pro full time, the ecosystem lock-in is real. For example, if I wanted to switch to Android, all of my smart home devices, which I have about 100, 150 devices, cameras, door locks, garage, everything is in Apple HomeKit, and much of it is not compatible with Google Home. So it would require changing all of this, totally upending my smart home platforms. In addition to smart home is screen time on iPhone. The moment I tried to use the Pixel 9 Pro full time, I realized all the requests from my kids, either more time on apps or just being able to manage all their settings, they all have iPads. My son has an iPhone. All that screen time, I would have to have them all switch to Android and able to manage their devices. And I have looked into Google Family Link. I have this set up because one of my kids used an Android device for a few months, and I might plan to do a whole video on this, but Google Family Link does not have the level and depth of control that screen time does for managing kids' devices, from the granular control over websites and other settings, location, contacts, downtime. It has some features, but it is just nowhere near as robust. I would also be missing features between my iPhone and Mac like AirDrop, Universal Clipboard, which I find out I use all the time and it stinks not to have it. Like I mentioned, all the shortcuts that I have on all my Apple devices, I would not have those on my iPhone. Also, another huge part of the iPhone is MagSafe. MagSafe chargers, MagSafe accessories. I have a ton of them. And while the Pixel 9 Pro can actually charge wirelessly, there is no MagSafe. I mean, you can put one of those little metal rings on the back and try to hack MagSafe accessories, but I just want MagSafe built into my phone. And there's some really unique niche apps that I use, like Transloader, and can't tell you what I do with that, but I'll link my website down in the video description. You could search there if you want to know what I do with that. I'd be missing those apps, which I have built into my ecosystem. Again, plus screen time, smart home, universal clipboard, AirDrop, all of that. So overall, the Pixel 9 Pro, it has great hardware. Android does have some cool features that I would love to see come to the iPhone, but the switching and ecosystem costs are way too great. Plus, I still prefer things like scrolling, the apps that I love, like Fantastical, Barren Things, on the iPhone, and certain things just don't have an equivalent on Android, like shortcuts, and that's a huge deal for me. And I will say this, if I had to choose between using an iPhone and a Windows machine, or an Android phone and a Mac, I would actually choose the latter. I still think my Mac is critical for my workflows. I edit videos in Final Cut, I've tried it on iPad, just no. But all of my workflows, my Mac, I really need it to get all of this stuff done, from videos to podcast creation, all of my workflows for productivity and notes and tasks, I can do all of that on my Mac. And I would be plenty happy using an Android phone like this. It takes great videos, great pictures, and honestly, RCS in iOS 18, as I've been using that on my iPhone, texting Android friends and family, it's actually really cool. I actually get red receipts delivered, send high quality images. RCS on iPhone is gonna make the switching cost a little less for some people. The fingerprint sensor is great, the display is awesome, love the size of the phone, battery life has been good the whole week I've been using it, and the Pixel 9 Pro XL is a great, great phone. Just one that I won't be using. I'll be on the iPhone. But let me know what you think. If you switch to Android or if the Pixel 9 Pro has been tempting you, leave comments down below this video, I'd love to hear from you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel before you go, hit that like button, and if you want to learn why I'm so passionate about shortcuts, I have an entire playlist on that, put that right up here. And if you want to learn about some of the features coming to iOS 18, like RCS, I have entire videos on that. I'll put one right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.